Dear students, welcome to the part 2 of your module 3, which is probability distributions. In part 1, we already discussed some of the basic definitions of random variables, discrete random variable, continuous random variable, probability mass function, probability density function, and cumulative density function. Now, using these basic properties and basic definitions, let us work out some problems today. Very simple problems, just we are making use of the conditions of PMF and PDF. Now, let us go to the first problem. A random variable x takes the values minus 3, minus 2, minus 1, 0, 1, 2, 3. Such that probability of x equal to 0 is equal to p of x less than 0, and p of x equal to minus 3 is equal to p of x equal to minus 2, which is equal to p of x equal to minus 1, which is same as p of x equal to 1, p of x equal to 2, and p of x equal to 3. So instead of giving the probabilities directly, they have given the relationship between these probabilities. Now, your first work is decision about the random variable. Decide whether your random variable x is discrete or continuous. Here, if you see the values taken by x, clearly values of x are listed. When the values of x can be listed like this, we take x as discrete random variable. So, clearly x is a discrete random variable. Now, we don't know all these probabilities for the corresponding values of x. Now let us denote probability at x equal to minus 3 as p1, first value of x as p1, and probability at second value of x as p2, probability at third value of x as p3. Like this, continue the procedure till p7. Okay, now for the time being, we don't know the values of this p1 to p7. Now what is the condition given? First condition, p of x equal to 0 is same as p of x less than 0. That means p of x equal to 0, as per our notation, it is p4. This p4 is same as p of x less than 0. Less than 0 means you have 3 values, minus 3, minus 2, minus 1. So all the corresponding probabilities, notations you have to add. So p1 plus p2 plus p3 gives you p of x less than 0. So what is given? First condition, p of x is equal to 0 is same as p of x less than 0. So this probability is same as sum of these three probabilities. So using the first condition, you get this relation. P4 is equal to P1 plus P2 plus P3. Take it as equation 1. Okay, still we don't know the values of this. Take it as equation 1. Now what is the second condition given in your question? P of x equal to minus 3, that means this probability is same as this probability. It is same as this probability, p of x equal to minus 1. It is same as p of x equal to 1. It is same as p of x equal to 2. And it is same as p of x equal to 3. So, 6 probabilities are equal. Okay. So, use the condition p1, p2, p3, p5, p6, p7 are equal. Let me take one single notation. Since all these terms are equal, let me take the values as k. So, let me take these values as k. Now, what is your equation 1 becomes now? P4 is equal to, this value is k. K plus k plus k, you get 3k. P4 is 3k. Now, use the second property of PMF. What is the second property of PMF? Sum of all probabilities will be equal to 1. So, use that property. Sum of all these probabilities will be equal to 1. Which are the probabilities? P1 to P7. So, add all probabilities from P1 to P7, sum should be equal to 1, and for P1, P2, etc., we have used the notation k. So, this is k, 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 but P4 is equal to 3k, substitute, and P5, P6, P7 are again equal to k plus k plus k. When you add all these k values, total you have 9k terms, so 9k, 9k is equal to 1. So, from this you get k value equal to 1 by 9. And once if you get the value of k, Here actually this is k. This is k. So once if you get the value of k, you can substitute the values here and obtain the probability distribution. So substitute the values of k and obtain the probability distribution. So first term is p1. p1 is k. p2 is k. p3 is k. But p4 is taken as 3k. So substitute. This is 3 by 9. 3k. And other values are equal to k. 1 by 9. So you obtain the probability distribution using the conditions given. And if you remember, what are the properties of probability mass function? All probabilities are greater than or equal to 0. You can verify here. And sum of all these values is equal to 1. Sum of all probabilities equal to 1. You can easily verify that property. So this is clearly a probability mass function given in your second row here. So this is a simple problem. It is required to just write the probability distribution. Now next problem. Is the function defined by f of x equal to e raised to minus x, where x is greater than 0, and f of x equal to 0 if x is less than 0 is a density function. So actually this is a function defined in two steps. Instead of two steps, they have given separately. For x greater than 0, function value is e raised to minus x, and otherwise, that means x less than 0, function value is 0. So check whether it is a density function. Density function means probability density function, PDF. If so, determine the probability that the variate having this density will fall in the interval 1, 2. So let us first check what is the random variable x, whether it is discrete or continuous. Here they have not mentioned that x values are integers. Only x greater than 0 condition is given. X greater than 0 means there are many real numbers more than 0. You cannot list them. So clearly x is a continuous random variable. So here x is a continuous random variable. Now if this function is a PDF, then it must satisfy two properties. What is the first property? All f of x values are greater than or equal to 0. And second condition, continuous random variable. So we use integration minus infinity to infinity f of x dx is equal to 1. Clearly we can observe that first condition is satisfied. Condition A. Why? Exponential function is never 0. Okay. So here clearly first condition is satisfied. And second condition, let us evaluate minus infinity to infinity f of x dx. Let us check whether this condition is satisfied. So when you integrate minus infinity to infinity f of x dx, you split the interval minus infinity to 0 and 0 to infinity. Why we are splitting this? Because function is defined in two steps, for x greater than 0 and for x less than 0. It is defined. Substitute. You get 0 to infinity. First definition, minus infinity to 0 means x less than 0. Definition is 0. And 0 to infinity, f of x is e raised to minus x. Integrate this. Integral of e raised to minus x is e raised to minus x divided by minus 1. So I have written that minus sign here. Apply the limits, 0 to infinity. Upper limit is 0. And lower limit is e raised to 0, that means 1. Okay, so you get minus 0 minus 1, answer is 1. So what is the condition required? Integration from minus infinity to infinity, f of x dx should be equal to 1. You obtained it. Clearly, condition B is also satisfied. Hence, f of x is a probability density function. Now, what is your second question? So we verified that it is a probability density function. If so, determine the probability that variate or variable having this density will fall in the interval 1, 2. Variate means x value. X is in between 1 and 2. What is the probability? So it is probability of 1 less than x less than 2. So integration from 1 to 2. Remember the property. Probability from A to B means integration from A to B. F of x dx. Integrate. If f of x is known, 1 to 2 means x is greater than 0, so you make use of first definition. Substitute, integrate, very simple integral. E raised to minus x integral is minus of e raised to minus x. Okay, substitute upper limit and lower limit. When you simplify this, you get the answer 0.2325. So a very simple question. Only they ask you to verify the PDF and find the probability in some interval. Next question. The probability density function of a random variable x is, values are given, x values are given and corresponding p of x values are given. Find p of x less than 4, p of x greater than or equal to 5 and p of 3 less than x less than or equal to 6. Here, how to decide whether it is discrete or continuous? Once again, x values are listed, so clearly it is discrete. I have not written here, it is understood. X values are discrete. So if p of x is a valid PDF, in that case these two conditions should satisfy. What is the first condition? All p of x values are greater than or equal to 0. That means all these second row values are greater than or equal to 0. So clearly from this condition you can say that x is k is greater than or equal to 0. And second condition, sum of all p of x values are equal to 1. Add all these p of x values given in your second row, equate it to 1, you get 49 times k equal to 1. That means k equal to 1 by 49. This gives you k value. Actually, here they didn't ask you the value of k, but without finding k, you cannot proceed. Okay, so find the value of k. First problem, p of x less than 4. See the table properly, x less than 4. Less than 4 means 4 is not included, all lesser values are included. So p of x equal to 0, p of x equal to 1, p of x equal to 2 and p of x equal to 3 are included. Add them. So p of x less than 4 means these 4 probabilities are added. You get 16 times k and substitute k value, you get 16 by 49. Next question, p of x greater than or equal to 5. Greater than or equal to 5 means equal to is included now, 5 and more than 5. So these two values, corresponding probabilities are added, 11k plus 13k. You get 24k, which is 24 by 49. P of 3 less than x less than or equal to 6. See the interval properly, less than and less than or equal to 6 means you have the difference. Less than 6 and less than or equal to 6, there is difference. Here 6 is included. 3 is not included. X is greater than 3. 3 is not included. So what you have to do? 6 is included. 3 is not included. So you have to add only these 3 terms. For x equal 4, x equal 5 and x equal to 6. 9k plus 11k plus 13k. So I already solved it here. Answer is 33 times k. Add and check it. You get the answer 33 by 49. Very simple problem in which only direct probabilities are asked. We are just adding and finding the probabilities. Next question. A random variable x has the following density function. P of x equal to kx square from minus 3 to 3, 0 elsewhere. Question is evaluate k and find p of 1 less than or equal to x less than or equal to 2 and p of x less than or equal to 2 and p of x greater than 1. So your first work is decision about the random variable. Here they have not mentioned whether x values are integers. If x values are integers, you can list the values from minus 3 to 3. But they have not mentioned. So you have to take all real numbers in the interval. Clearly x is continuous. You cannot list all the values. So x is a continuous random variable. You can write first sentence as x is a continuous random variable. So once if you decide about the random variable, which are the conditions for PDF? Given that this is a density function, probability density function. So these two conditions should hold good. Which is the first condition? P of x greater than or equal to 0. All probability values should be greater than or equal to 0. And integration of P of x dx is equal to 1. So from the first condition, P of x greater than or equal to 0, clearly you can say that this k is greater than or equal to 0. Because if k is negative, k into x square will be negative. It is not possible. So k will be greater than or equal to 0. So you got one idea about the value of k. That means you cannot have negative values for k. K is greater than or equal to 0. Now what is the second condition? Integration of p of x from minus infinity to infinity is equal to 1. So substitute, what is k p of x? P of x means k into x square. Integration from actually minus infinity to infinity. But as per your first definition, only this interval is enough, minus 3 to 3, kx square dx. Integrate, it is a very simple integral, k into x cube by 3, apply the limits. You will get this answer is equal to k, equal to 1, this answer is equal to 1. Simplify this, I have not shown the simplification steps here. Finally, you will get k equal to 1 by 18. That means here, this left hand side will be 18k. 18k will be equal to 1. That means k equal to 1 by 18. So you got the answer for your first question. Evaluate k. Next question. Find p of 1 less than or equal to x less than or equal to 2. Okay, since this is a continuous random variable, we are using integration to find the probability. In the case of continuous random variable, there is no difference between less than or equal to x. Okay, integration is, limits are same. Even if they ask you to find p of 1 less than x less than 2, then also we take the limits from 1 to 2. Okay, there is no difference between less than and less than or equal to in the case of continuous. But remember, in the case of discrete, you have the difference. Remember this. So substitute, what is your function p of x? We are integrating from 1 to 2, f of x dx. I have not written here f of x dx, directly I substituted. What is f of x? F of x is k into x square. K is 1 by 18 and x square. Integrate this, very simple integration, x cube by 3, apply the limits, you will get finally 7 by 54. So pause this video, calculate each term, verify. Calculate and verify yourself. Next question, p of x less than or equal to 2. Less than or equal to 2 means all lesser values starting from minus infinity to 2 are considered. But minus infinity to till minus 3, actually minus infinity to till 2 as per the condition, but minus infinity to till minus 3, it comes in this definition. So only it is enough if you start from minus 3. So I am writing here it as minus 3 to 2 instead of minus infinity to 2. Substitute the function value k into x square, integrate, apply the limits. You get 35 by 54. And remember, all probability values are in between 0 and 1. You cannot have any answer more than 1. By mistake, if you write it as 54 by 35, then it is actually greater than 1. It is not possible. Remember. Next question, p of x greater than 1. Greater than 1 means 1 to till infinity. But 1 to 3 only you can consider to use the first definition. After 3, only up to 3 it is defined here. After 3, it comes in your second definition. So 1 to 3 function k into x square. K is 1 by 18, x square dx. Integrate. You know the integration. Apply the limits. You get the answer 13 by 27. So this is a question from continuous random variable. Now I am giving you some practice problems. Already we worked out 2 to 3 problems. Now practice problems. The first question, the probability density function of a random variable x is, it is given, find k, find p of 3 less than x less than or equal to 5. Okay. How to find k? First check whether values of x are listed. Yes. So this is a discrete random variable. Next to find p of x. So when you find p of x, actually required value is p of 3 less than. So find the exact value of p of x after finding k. Then 3 less than x less than or equal to 5 means 3 is not included. Only 4 and 5 are included. Okay. So you get 9k. K will be 1 by 36. I have given you the answer here. Just verify. And 9k means you get 9k plus 11k, 20k, that means 20 by 36. Very simple question, which is asked in recent question paper of VTU. Similarly, another question, slightly different. Why it is different? Here the values of f of x are And remember, don't worry about the notation. They may give you p of x or f of x. Don't depend on the notation. You just see the values. Whether if values of x are listed, it is discrete. So this is another example of discrete. So k, 2k, 2k, 3k, k square, 2k square, 7k square plus k. Here some square terms are also included. So when you use the condition of PDF or PMF, sum of all p of x values will be equal to 1. Here sum of all f of x values will be equal to 1. You will get a quadratic equation containing k square term, k term and constant term. Solve the quadratic equation, you know, you will get two values. Out of them, one value will be negative. I am not working out this here. It is asked in the recent question paper, but still, already in your statistics part, I solved this question. So just go through the video class of your statistics class, the class 1, first class, up under application problems, we worked out these problems. Okay. So once again, go through that problem. Same problem is worked out. You will get k equal to 1 by 10 and p of x less than 3 will be 3 by 10. So just verify whether you get these answers. Otherwise, you can always ask me. This is second practice problem for you. Now next problem, if the random variable x takes the values 1, 2, 3, 4 such that 2 into p of x equal to 1 is equal to 3 into p of x equal to 2 is equal to p of x equal to 3 equal to 5 into p of x equal to 4. Okay, again, a relationship between the probabilities are given. Using this, you have to find the exact probabilities. Find the probability distribution. This is similar to your first worked out problem. Okay. Anyway, under statistics class, again, this problem is worked out. Just go through it. Okay. These topics, especially functions of single random variable, problems under PDF and CDF are common in your both subjects, statistics as well as mathematics. So this is a worked out problem under statistics class. In your video class, it is worked out. Just verify. Okay. So here I am only giving you the solution. Just verify whether you get this solution. And find the cumulative distribution function. So even CDF is asked. And this is another similar question. Suppose a random variable x takes the values. Instead of giving the values in the tabular form, they have given the values separately. Values of x are minus 3, minus 1, 2 and 5. With the respective probabilities, 2k minus 3 by 10, k minus 2 by 10, k minus 1 by 10 and k plus 1 by 10. So what is the meaning? When x equal to minus 3, corresponding probability is this, 2k minus 3 by 10. When x equal to minus 1, corresponding probability is this. So instead of table, they have given in sentence form. So find the value of k. How to find the value of k? You add all probability values and equate it to 1. You will get the value of k. So here I have given you the answers, just verify. After finding value of k, these two probabilities are asked. But be careful, minus 3 less than x less than 4 means minus 3 is not included, 4 is also not included. Minus 3 is not included, 4 is not included means anyway 4 is not there in your list. Less than 4 means only minus 1 and 2. These two probabilities you have to add. That means these two values, k minus 2 by 10 and k minus 1 by 10. And second question, p of x less than or equal to 2. Less than or equal to 2 means 2 is included as well as lesser values are included. So for x equal to minus 3, x equal to minus 1 and x equal to 2. These three values you have to add. 2k minus 3 by 10, k minus 2 by 10 and k minus 1 by 10. Add and substitute the value of k. You will get the answer 0.4. So today we discussed only simple problems from probability density function and probability mass function. Under both discrete and continuous random variables, we worked out the problems today. Okay. So in the next class, we will discuss about mean and variance of a random variable and work out some more problems under these topics. Already you studied even mean and variances are also studied under your statistics classes. So just recall, so you will find it easy. Thank you.